Good morning, dear students. I hope you all must have read this story and enjoyed this chapter. Today, I am going to analyze this chapter. We will first know the chapter in a nutshell, or rather we will discuss the summary of the chapter, and also we are going to discuss the character sketch of Anne Frank and the highlights of the chapter. So please keep watching the video. Thank you. From the diary of Anne Frank. Now this is a famous quote of Anne Frank, and which is very inspiring. You can see that laziness might be attractive, but work gives satisfaction. So in this quote, you can understand that laziness gives happiness to everyone. Everyone likes to enjoy the lazy time and not to do any work, but work gives satisfaction, which is more enjoyable. So that is how Anne Frank felt about work. Now let us quickly go through the summary of this chapter. In this lesson, Anne talks about being lonely and having no one to talk to, despite being surrounded by family and around 30 people whom she called her friends. Thus, she takes the decision of writing her feelings in a diary. It is unusual for her to write in a diary, but she is really in need of a true friend. Thus, she decides to name her diary Kitty, and unlike other people, she is not going to mention just facts in it. She starts with writing her background to make it easier to understand for anyone who reads it later. She describes her family and early childhood when they all migrated, her early schooling. After giving a brief account of her background, she comes to the present day, where she tells us about the result today. Everyone in the class is nervous about their result, and boys are even making bets. Anne was quite sure about herself and her friends. She had a good equation with all the teachers except her maths professor, who was constantly annoyed at her for her talking habits. Thus, he started giving her punishments in the form of essays on weird topics such as chatterbox, to which she replied with full wit. Wit means understanding, intelligence. She wrote essays that were funny and explained that this was a trait. Trait means quality that she inherited from her mother, and not much could be done about it. He kept on giving her essays until she wrote a satire. After that third and last assignment, Mr. Keesing never pointed her out for talking. So let us have a review of the chapter. Anne's first years. Anne Frank was born in the German city of Frankfurt am Main. Main is the name of the river on which this city was there, in 1929. Anne's sister Margaret was 3 years her senior. That is, she had an elder sister whose name was Margaret. Unemployment was high and poverty was severe in Germany, and it was the period in which Adolf Hitler and his party were gaining more and more supporters. Hitler hated the Jews and blamed them for the problems in the country. He took advantage of the rampant anti-Semitic sentiments in Germany. The hatred of Jews and the poor economic situation made Anne's parents, Otto and Edith Frank, decide to move to Amsterdam. There, Otto founded a company that traded in pectin, a gelling agent for making jam. When Anne and her family had forcibly been shifted to Netherlands, there Nazi Germany invaded the Netherlands. Before long, Anne felt right at home in the Netherlands. She learned the language, made new friends, and went to a Dutch school near her home. Her father worked hard to get his business off the ground, but it was not easy. Otto also tried to set up a company in England, but the plan fell through. Plan fell through means it did not work out. It failed. Things looked up when he started selling herbs and spices in addition to the pectin. On 1st September 1939, when Anne was 10 years old, Nazi Germany invaded Poland, and so the Second World War began. Not long after, on 10th May 1940, the Nazis also invaded the Netherlands. 5 days later, the Dutch army surrendered. Slowly but surely, the Nazis introduced more and more laws and regulations that made the lives of Jews more difficult. For instance, Jews could no longer visit parks, cinema, or non-Jewish shops. The rules meant that more and more places became off-limits to Anne. Her father lost his company, since Jews were no longer allowed to run their own businesses. All Jewish children, including Anne, had to go to separate Jewish schools. Anne keeps a diary. On her 13th birthday, just before they went into hiding, Anne was presented with a diary. During the 2 years in hiding, Anne wrote about events in the secret annex, but also about her feelings and thoughts. In addition, she wrote short stories, started on a novel, and copied passages from the books she read in her Book of Beautiful Sentences. In this way, writing helped her pass the time in the hiding. Anne's diary became world famous. Anne's writing made a deep impression on Otto. Otto was Anne's father, Otto Frank. He read that Anne had wanted to become a writer or a journalist, and that she had intended to publish her stories about life in the secret annex. Friends convinced Otto to publish the diary, and in June 1947, 3,000 copies of her Het Asterius, The Secret Annex, were printed. And that was not all. The book was later translated into around 70 languages and adapted for stage and screen. Stage and screen means it was filmed, and also a stage, that is, plays were also made on the basis of that. This diary. People all over the world were introduced to Anne's story, and in 1960, the hiding place became a museum, the Anne Frank House. Until his death in 1980, Otto remained closely involved with the Anne Frank House and the museum. He hoped that the readers of the diary would become aware of the dangers of discrimination, racism, and hatred of Jews. Now let us discuss the message of the chapter. The diary ends suddenly on 1st August 1944. There are many important messages in this book, but the most important message is that all people have the right to live in freedom. Anne's story shows us that just because people may be of a different religion or race does not mean that they should be treated differently. So this is the message of this chapter, because Anne Frank was a Jewish girl belonging to a Jewish family, and she has written about the ill treatment of the Jews by the Germans. So it is the main theme of the story, that though the people belong to different religion or race, they should not be treated indifferently or maltreated. So now let us discuss the character sketch of Anne Frank. She was lively, happy and cheerful even in an awful situation. The second point that you're going to include in your answer will be she had a flair for writing and describing people. She was brave as she coped up with the monotony of the hiding. Talkative, inquisitive and perceptive. Intelligent and wise as a young girl. This quality is called as precocious. Extraordinary vitality, optimism, hunger for knowledge and creativity. All these are the qualities of Anne Frank. She was empathetic and sensitive at the age of 15. Considerate and compassionate for fellow Jews. Now look at the previous point in that empathetic means not only having sympathy but also feeling the same pain and suffering of the other Jews, other people. Introspective and thoughtful. She wanted to become a writer and therefore later on in her hiding where she started writing her diary, when she grew up she was having this introspection and she was very thoughtful about the people in the hiding along with her. So dear children, you are supposed to write the question or a long answer question on character sketch of Anne Frank. I have just given you the points, but you are going to incorporate all these points with the instances or examples from the chapter. Now, it should begin, the answer should begin with the introduction to Anne Frank, who she was and what was the problem that they were facing as Jews. And then you can write down all these things. Now, for example, she was talkative, inquisitive and perceptive. So there you can include the example of the class where she has narrated the incident of the maths teacher, Mr. Keesing, and how when Mr. Keesing was fed up of her talkativeness and how she was inquisitive and perceptive that she wanted to write in a different manner and how she wrote the essay on the topic in a poetic form or a verse form. And she was intelligent also because she did not want to become a fool of the teacher, and the teacher was making a joke of her and how intelligently she turns the table around at her table, at her teacher. And so this, all these things you will be explaining the qualities that I have given you in your answer. So now we are going to look at the highlights of the chapter. Anne Frank lived in Holland after Hitler invaded. They lived in hiding for many years to survive. Her father and mother left her and her sister to her grandma. She was very close to her grandma. After her death, she felt very much alone. She was gifted a diary on her 13th birthday and she named it Kitty. It was her best friend in her loneliness. She wrote every problem and happenings in her diary. She was lovable of every teacher except Mr. Keesing, who taught maths. Mr. Keesing got annoyed with her talkative nature. So he punished her by giving her extra homework many a time. He asked her to write an essay on the topic a chatterbox as punishment. She wrote the essay in verse form on topic quack 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 said Mistress Chatterbox, which humiliated Mr. Keesing. He allowed her to talk and relieved her from any extra homework. So these are the highlights of the chapter. You can pay attention to these points while you're writing your answers. Thank you. Now dear students, in your book we have only the excerpt from the diary of Anne Frank, but the movie that was made on the complete book, we are going to read about the whole story of Anne Frank from this review of the film. In 1945, as a truckload of war survivors stops in front of an Amsterdam factory at the end of World War II, Otto Frank gets out and walks inside. After climbing the stairs to a deserted garret, Otto finds a girl's discarded glove and sobs. Then is joined and comforted by Mayor Gaze and Mr. Kraler, office workers who shielded him from the Nazis. So this is the beginning of the movie. How does the movie begin? It shows the period of 1945 when Otto Frank, who was the only survivor from Frank's family, had come along with the other war survivors to Amsterdam factory. And there, when he, after climbing the stairs to a deserted garret, garret is an attic, it's the small room on the terrace. And when he goes there, he finds a glove and sobs. Sobs are the crimes of the girl. Then he is comforted by the office workers who had shielded him, who had saved him and protected him from the Nazis. Now, Nazis were officially known as National Socialist German Social Workers. And these Nazis, they were very rude to the Jews and they had ill-treated the Jewish community there in Germany. So the movie starts like that, and then after stating that he is now all alone, Otto begins to search for the diary written by his youngest daughter, Anne. Mapp promptly retrieves it for him and he receives solace reading the words written by Anne 3 years earlier. So when Otto Frank, who was the only survivor, came back to the same hiding place and he found his daughter's diary there, when he started reading it, he felt comforted and he remembered Anne, who had written the diary 3 years earlier. In the first pages of her diary, she has described the strangeness of never being able to go outside or breathe fresh air. She states that everybody is good at heart. As the months pass by, Anne's irrepressible energy reasserts itself and she constantly teases Peter, whose only attachment is to his cat Mushi. Isolated from the world outside, Otto schools Annie and her sister Margaret. As the sounds of sirens and bombers frequently fill the air, Mrs. Van Dahn passes the time by recounting fond memories of her youth and stroking her one remaining possession, the fur coat given to her by her father. The strain of confinement causes the Van Dahns to argue and pits the strong-willed Anne against her mother, Edith Frank. One day, Kraler brings a radio to the attic, providing the families with ears onto the world, which means trying to update them with the latest news. So he brought a radio that day. Soon after, he asks them to take in another person, a Jewish dentist named Albert Dussel, when Van Dahn complains that the addition will diminish their food supply. Dussel recounts the dire conditions outside in which Jews suddenly disappear and are shipped to concentration camps. When Dussel confirms the disappearance of many of their friends, the families' hopes are dimmed. So, in all, in the hiding, there were 8 persons, 4 of Frank's family, that is Anne Frank's father, mother, her sister, and she herself, and Van Dahn's, Mr. and Mrs. Van Dahn's, and their son Peter, and one more was introduced to them was Mr. Dussel, who was a doctor. Although Van Dahn's had raised an objection that if Dr. Dussel was included into the group in the hiding, they would run out of food supply. But later on, he was also housed there in that hiding. One night Anne dreams of seeing one of her friends in a concentration camp and wakes up screaming. In October 1942, news comes of the Allied landing in Africa, but the bombing of Amsterdam intensifies, fraying the refugees' already ragged nerves. That is, all these Jewish people or the Jews who were living in fear, they all were afraid of the continuous bombing of the Amsterdam. So their already ragged nerves, that is, those who were in fear and nervous because of the attack by the Germans, they were still more afraid because of the bombing. During Hanukkah is a Jewish festival. They now hear in her diary, and Frank has remembered the past. So while she was in the hiding with her family and the other people, she was remembering the past, which she has mentioned in the diary. During Hanukkah, which is a Jewish festival, Margot, her sister, longingly recalls past celebrations, and Anne produces little presents for everyone. When Van Daan abruptly announces that Peter must get rid of Moshe because he consumes too much food, Anne protests. So here you can see another character of Anne Frank, that she did not want to get rid of the cat just because it consumed too much of food. She was animal loving, and she was very kind to the animals too. Their argument is cut short when they hear a prowler break in the front of the door, and the room falls silent. So at that time they hear a prowler break in. Break in means to barge in, to get inside the house forcibly. And a prowler is a person who breaks into the houses to steal. Peter then sends an object crashing to the floor while trying to catch Moshe, and the startled thief, that prowler who was a thief, grabs a typewriter and flees. So he could only steal the typewriter because Peter had thrown something on the floor which crashed and made a loud sound, due to which the thief ran away from there. And he had done so because they were in the hiding and they should not be detected by anybody else. Therefore, he wanted the person or the thief to flee away from there, to run away from there. A watchman notices the break-in and summons two police officers who search the premises, shining their flashlights onto the bookcase that conceals the attic entrance. So the hiding place was blocked by a bookcase, the stand in which you keep the books. So they were hiding behind that. They were in the attic, and this entrance to the attic was blocked by the bookcase. But when there was noise and they heard the break-in of the thief, the watchman noticed it and summoned two police officers who checked or searched the premises, and they had the flashlights. The families wait in terror. The families wait in terror until Moshe knocks a plate from the table and mews, reassuring the officers that the noise was caused by a common cat. So here you can see that Anne Frank has mentioned about the cat, that it mewed and knocked the plate from the table, which made the police officers feel that the noise was caused by the cat and nothing else. By July 1944, the invasion has bogged down and Kreller is hospitalized with ulcers. Upon hearing that the police have found the stolen typewriter, Anne writes that her diary provides her with a way to go on living after her death. After the Van Daans begin to quarrel once more, Peter declares that he cannot tolerate the situation and and soothes him by reminding him of the goodness of those who have come to their aid. Their conversation is interrupted by the sirens of an approaching police truck. As Anne and Peter bravely stand arm in arm, certain of their impending arrest, they passionately kiss. As the German in uniformed police break down the bookcase entrance to the hideout, Otto declares they no longer have to live in fear but can go forward in hope. So because the police had found out the stolen typewriter, they could get a lead towards these people who were hiding in the attic, and Otto and the other group members were all discovered by the police. The film returns to 1945 as Otto tells Mayep and Kreiler that on his long journey home after his release from the concentration camp, he learned how Edith, Margaret, the Van Dans and Dassel perished, but always held out hope that perhaps Anne had somehow survived. He sadly reveals that only the previous day in Rotterdam he met a woman who had been in Bergen Belsen with Anne and confirmed her death. He then glances at Anne's diary and reads, "In spite of everything, I still believe that people are really good at heart," and reflects upon her unshakable optimism. So in the character sketch of Anne Frank, you will see, you can add this quality that she was very optimistic. So this is the whole story of the diary of Anne Frank.